Welcome back to Haaretz.com. I'm Aimee Amiga, and I'm here again with Dr. Harold Rhode for part two of our conversation on the Islamic State and America's involvement in Iraq. Thank you for joining us again. On Friday, the Obama administration said that it has begun forming a coalition of countries to combat the Islamic State group, and it said this could serve as a model for eradicating terrorism in the Middle East. Now, why is it important for the United States to enroll other countries in its ambitions to eradicate terrorism in the Middle East?
Well, that may make the Obama administration feel nice and feel good about itself. But in the Middle East, what they need is a strong man, a strong leader. And the question that America brings in other people is secondary. In fact, it's irrelevant. Is America prepared to do what is necessary to eradicate these terrorists? If the answer to that is yes, people will come and join you. If not, then America, you can't lead from behind. It's a beautiful phrase. It's meaningless. What America has proven, unfortunately, in the last few years, it is a harmless enemy and an unreliable ally. And that is the problem.
Are you saying that they're just portraying weakness now?
Yes, they're portraying weakness.
And why is it America's role to be the one then to eradicate terrorism in the Middle East?
Because America is the strongest power in the world, whether it likes it or not. We in the United States don't want to be the world's policeman. If we're imperialists, when have you ever heard in history that an imperialist comes in and devises an exit strategy? That's absurd. America doesn't want this. It wants everybody to get along, to be nice, to negotiate. You give in a little, I give in a little. But it isn't the way of the Middle East. Middle Easters don't think this way.
Some have suggested that the United States and Iran could team up against this common threat that they perceive in Islamic State. Is that likely to happen, and could it work?
I would hope not.
Why?
And here's why. Many times during the Cold War, America and the Soviet Union had common interests in a particular problem. So they talked about it, and one did one thing, one did another. But there was no question that the Americans understood that the Soviet Union was the enemy at all times. Iran is one of the most fascinating cultures in the Middle East. They know how to wait, and they play chess very well. What is chess? It's a game of strategy. They think 3-4 moves ahead. And they are trying to entice the Americans to give in, to give them time to develop the nuclear weapons. Once they have nuclear weapons, then all bets are off, because everybody will realize America let them do it. That's how they'll understand it, and they understand it now. And they will then kowtow to Iran, and it'll be a total loss for the United States of America. How awful. Yes, you're right that they have, shall we say, a particular goal in common now. But in the long term, America and Iran are this government, not the Iranian people, not Iran as a country. This government of Iran, and they make it very clear in the secret language called Persian that they speak, that they hate America. America is the enemy, and America must be destroyed.
So you're saying it would be a mistake for America to join forces with Iran?
Absolutely.
All right, thank you very much for joining us, Dr. Harold Rhode. I'm Aimee Amiga, and you're on Haaretz.com.